leader around you that one day they will become strong to become leaders where? In their own right. That one, they come to support you because they want to learn from you. They want to digest from you. That why you see assistant coaches end up becoming head coaches in other schools and in other colleges. Because they learn from the head coach, and the whole head coach imparted into them his experience and his way of doing things. Today we have one of the best coaches in Ohio State, yet he started right here in Bowling Green under another coach. Somebody say, praise the Lord. So you learn how to impact your experience, your knowledge, and your ways of doing things into others. To make them better leaders in their own right. That one day, peace of you will be with them. Peace of you will go with them. Peace of you will be in their mind. Peace of you will be in their spirit. Somebody shall say hallelujah. Say never pass it on. That leaders. Leader pass on the experience. Leader pass on the experience. But yes, your business will not grow if you are selfish with your knowledge. Is that right? Your business will not survive if you are selfish. That what happened to Shaka Zulu. He was so gifted and he did not want for no one to be like him. So anyone that was trying to be like him, killed him. Even his own biological child. Somebody said, praise the Lord. Somebody said, Lord, I thank you.
Lord, thank you.
Yes, 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 yes. Yeah. They use their position, relationship, and productivity to invest in their followers and develop them until those followers become leaders in their own right. The result is what? Production. Leader reproduce themselves. Hallelujah. Leader does what? Reproduce themselves.
Alright.
Does that make sense?
Well.
Your father, your grandfather reproduce himself through your father. And your father is reproducing you like him. Leader does what? Reproduce themselves.
Alright.
I'm reproducing myself in them. And all of my children. They may not live with me 24/7, but honey, I talk to them. I talk with them. They see my ways of doing things. They may not do it at my level, but someday they will take it to the next level. Leader does what? Reproduce themselves. Don't just look like me, but try to do something like me. Somebody say praise the Lord. I'm talking about the good habits. Leave a negative habit of mine. Just follow one good habit that you can cleave to. That they will say, well, he looked just like his dad. Or she looked just like her mother. She can cook just like her mama. Or he can get drunk and dry like his father. Somebody say praise the Lord. Level 4, yes. Make leaders. Production may win games. Listen to this. I like this. Production may win games, but people development win championship.
Yes.
All right. Is that right, neighbor? Production may win games. But
human development
win championship. That's why Tom Brady is a champion all the time because the coach developed him.
That's right.
Does that make sense at all?
All right.
Does that make sense at all? Somebody say praise the Lord. Human development wins championship. Production may win games, but people development win championship. Two things always happen on level 4. First, teamwork goes to a very high level. Because the high investment in people deepens relationship, help people to know one another better, strengthen loyalty. Second, performance increases. Why? Because there are more leaders on the team and they have to improve everybody's performance. There are more, when you get more leaders on your team, when you get more leaders on your team, because they all know how. Always surround yourself with people that know stuff. You want people around you that you can push, not pull. There's no a time that you raise your children by pulling them. But after you have invested so much in them, and you know that they can do it now by themselves, but you just have to give them the confidence by pushing them.
Alright.
Is that right?
Amen.
You give them the confidence by what? By pushing them.
Amen.
I'm taking a week off, now carry it on.
I know
who's the Lord talking to you here? Somebody shout say, praise the Lord. I'm taking a week off, now carry it on. Yeah, it's a car key. Go to the store and get me some stuff from Maya. Get me some stuff from Kroger. No matter how you had to shave up before me, just go get my stuff. You got to push them. Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Just make sure you got good insurance on the car. Just make sure you get good insurance on the car.
Extra key.
Extra key.
Extra key.
Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh, yeah, because you are invested in them. You want them to be the leaders that you are, or more than you.
Amen.
Is there anybody getting anything from this?
Yes.
You want them. You want the leaders.
Yes.
You want your children or your loved one or people that God has given you leadership over to do better than you can do.
Yes.
To always improve. Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Somebody say, Lord, we thank you.
Lord, thank you.
Oh, yes, yes. Leadership.
Yes.
Leadership. Let me repeat that one once again. Yes, yes, yes. Level 4, leaders change the lives of the people.
Yes.
They lead. Level 4, leaders change the lives of the people. They lead. Because there are more leaders on the team and they help to improve everybody's performance.
Amen.
Is that right?
Amen.
Accordingly, their people follow them because of what their leader has done for them personally. And their relationship are often lifelong. Because of your input in their life, they seek always to have a relationship with you. You become mentor in their life. You become somebody that they can call when things get a little bit tougher along the route. Somebody shout, say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You become so close, there's a saying that there are some friends that can stay closer to you than brothers or sisters. Because of your input into their life. They become now, they have now become part of your family. Somebody shout, say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
They have become part of your family because you were not stingy with them. You were not selfish with them. You were willing to give to them what God has blessed you with.
Amen.
The treasure that God has built in you. Hallelujah. The wisdom, the knowledge, and the understanding that over the years you are gained because of your relationship with the good Lord. Somebody say, Lord, I thank you.
Lord, I thank
somebody
you.
Say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Level 4, develop long-lasting relationship.
Yes.
Now, level 5 is different.
Amen.
Level 5 is not for everybody.
Yeah.
Level 5 is not for everybody. Level 5 is for the gifted ones. Because you and I can ride the same car.
Right.
That's what the devil did not know. The devil thought he knew everything about God, but God left one portion that he did not know about.
Well.
Level 5 for gifted people. Anointed people. Yeah. People with 6 hands, not 5. Is that right? Amen. So there are some level that a leader can go, that everybody can go. Does that make sense at all? Does that make sense at all? But you have to go through level 1, level 2, level 3, level 4 before you get to level 5. You get don't jump there overnight. It's a long walk. Is that right? It's a long walk. No matter how sophisticated your child may be, you stay the daddy. Or you stay the mama. There are some tricks that you know that she don't know about. Is that right? Somebody else, there's some, come on now. There are something about you that he just can't grasp. He can run faster than you. Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
But you can still beat him at the finishing line. Because he, come on now.
Well,
somebody say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
In conclusion, level 5. Level 5 is pinnacles. The pinnacle of power. The highest and most difficult level of leadership is the pinnacle. While more people can learn to climb to level 1 through 4, level 5 requires not only effort, skill, and intentionality, but also a high level of what? Talents. Ooh! High level of talents. High level of gift. Not everybody is willing to fast that I can fast. Because as the head of the ship, you are asking God every day to give you that revelatory spirit,
right,
to see what's going on.
Amen.
You see things that others don't see.
Amen.
Is that right?
Amen.
You see things that the workers don't see.
So true.
Although they are loyal to you.
Right.
But it is not their place of thinking. It is your place of thinking. They are only looking to you for directives. Somebody say, Lord, I thank you. Because you are the captain of that ship.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Only naturally gifted leaders ever make it to the highest level.
Woo.
Only naturally what? Gifted leaders. Somebody say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Can I repeat that once again? Only what? Naturally what? Gifted leaders that have ever made it to level 5. And I believe in my heart that you all here are gifted in your own unique ways. God did not leave you out of the blessing. Somebody say, Lord, I thank you.
Lord, I thank you.
God what, did not leave you out of the blessing. You have your place of assignment.
Yes.
And as you come into your pinnacle of power,
Lord,
there are things and there are incidences or things that will happen that you just have to stand alone or all by yourself. Does that make sense? You understand? By yourself. Mama will not be there all the time. Daddy not going to be there. The gates is open to you now. You are the one that in charge right now. Does that make sense? Does that make sense? You are the one that in charge. So when things start to shake, they look to you now and say, you are the one at level 5.
Yeah.
You are that leader that were there and with your name written. Jeremiah, before you enter your mother womb, I knew thee.
Amen.
And I place this assignment upon you. Somebody say hallelujah. I place the assignment upon you. If nobody pray with you, you better learn how to pray.
All right. Come on with it.
Oh, come on. Come on. I'm taking you somewhere. If no one pray with you, you better learn how to pray. If nobody fast with you, you better learn how to fast. Because you are at level 5. You are at a level where they cannot reach. They can just bring you thus far. Is that right? They can just bring you thus far despite of their good intention. Is that right? Despite of their loyalty. Is that right? Despite of their backing, there are certain rooms that you can enter that they cannot enter. Because they are not prepared for that room. Despite of Joshua stealing by Moses. Despite of Aaron and his sons standing by Moses. Only Moses alone was allowed to enter in the holiest of holies. Oh, come on, can I preach to you now? Only Moses alone was allowed to enter in the holiest of holies, where he and God alone were together and God were able to speak to him. Somebody shall say, praise the Lord. So yes, yes, you can train leaders to be around you. You can have an open door policy to encourage people to stand by you. Somebody shall say, praise the Lord. You can have loyal following. Following holding you up as pillars that you can lean on. But when the question comes, the authority are not coming to them. When the question comes, the family are not calling them for prayer. When the question comes, the mothers are not calling them for prayer. When the question comes, the father are not calling them for prayer, but they are looking up to the head. Somebody shouts and praise the Lord.
Praise
the
Lord.
So when you are asking God, can I have a head here now?
Right.
When you are asking God to make you the head, not the tail, test the water whether you are qualified to be the head. Test the water whether you are qualified for your sleep to be disturbed. Hallelujah. For your pressure time of relaxing to be disturbed. Because some mother wants a prayer for her child. Some husband wants a prayer for his wife. Somebody shout, say glory to God. So when you are asking, can I have a happier now? When you are asking God to make you the head, not the tail, your prayer to be answered. Your prayer to be answered. God may lift you up to that position of power. God may lift you up to that areas of power. But are you ready to carry on what the work the job takes? What it takes to do the job? What it takes to pray for somebody? What it takes to fight for somebody? What it takes to intercede for somebody? You do it. The patience to talk to them in the way, in their breathing hours, in the hour of darkness, in the hour of loneliness. Do you have any things to talk with them? That's level 5. Level 5, you are all by yourself. Level 5, you have to stay up all night to do the paperwork. Come on, is there a witness at this morning? I wonder who the Lord talking to at this hour. Only at level 5 takes all night. You have to stay up all night to do the paperwork. You have to go from law offices to law offices. Because somebody did some dumb stuff. All falling on you. Somebody say, praise the Lord. Level 5 force you to travel out of your comfort zone. Is that right? It force you to travel out of your comfort zone. You leave your husband and your children behind. to travel out of your comfort zone because you are the one the authority is looking up to. Somebody say, praise the Lord. You have been chosen among thousands of people because God planted his soul. God has invested in you over the years. Somebody say, hallelujah. He has invested in you over the years. Now your time of coming forward is at hand. Senator, your time of coming to the light. Yes, your time of coming. Oh, glory to God. Your time of coming in the presence of great men and great women is at hand. Because my Bible says, your gaze shall make a room for you. Is that what the Bible says? Say, neighbor, your gaze will make room for you. Your gaze will bring you before great men and great women. And there are witnesses here. Come on, stand on your feet and bless the Lord with me. You did not forget about me. I thank you. When you went about blessing your people, when you went about, yes, favoring people, when you went about favoring people, you did not forget about me. Righteous man fall, but every time he falls, God pick him up. He can fall at level one, God still pick him up. He can fall at level two, God still pick him up. He can fall at level three, God said he's my child. I will still pick him up and keep on pushing him. My goodness! Shall continue to push you. Say, neighbor, God's goodness and his mercy will continue to push you. Hallelujah. Come on, push somebody by. Say, neighbor, God's goodness. Come on, push them on their back. Say, neighbor, God's goodness. Come on, push them by. Push them by. Say, neighbor, God's goodness. Oh, thank you.